Hey, Ron here from HVAC Training Solutions. If you stick with me for a couple of minutes at the end of this video, you'll get a free HVAC training lesson. It will give you a taste of the type of training we do online. So you're probably there in Cleveland. You've been looking high and low online, calling around, checking the HVAC trade schools, HVAC colleges, and the online courses, and it gets pretty confusing. And you're trying to figure out which course is right for you, and even if the HVAC industry is right for you. So let's take a look at the industry. This might help you out a little bit. The jobs are growing 21% faster than the national average. And also, I just read where the HVAC technicians that are getting older are leaving the career field, and there are five times more older technicians leaving the HVAC career field then there are new technicians entering the career field. So this means as time goes on, there will be more and more HVAC jobs available. The average salary is $45,000 a year, and I know technicians who make $60,000 to $65,000 a year, but they are highly trained, top-notch technicians with 3 to 5 years experience under their belt. They are students of the trade, and they're great, great technicians. There's always jobs available. It doesn't matter what city, state, or country you look in, HVAC technicians are in high demand. This is a thinking man's trade. You have to be a welder, electrician, plumber, troubleshooter, salesman, and counselor. And the HVAC trade is getting more and more technical as the years go by. So is online training right for you? You know, I don't know. It's not for everybody, and the career field's not for everybody. But if you are motivated to get into the HVAC career field, to keep your job, and to start out on the right foot with the right education, we might be the ones for you. And you know, if you think it's right for you, or even if you're not sure, give me a call. 904-742-9511. I will be more than happy to talk to you about anything and everything that we have to offer. And if there's anything I can do to help you, please let me know. Now, stand by for your free training. Hey guys, this morning I'm going to use the HVAC training simulator that we have in our HVAC technician course to show you what happens to the system pressures and temperatures when there's a dirty filter. Now, we already know that there's a dirty filter just to speed up the diagnosis here, but the dispatch page says you have inadequate or no cooling. Customer's not home and left the house open to begin work. So let's first pop into the indoor unit and let's take a look at that filter just so you can see. It is all dirty. We'll put it away, put the cover back on. Let's run out to the outdoor unit and see if the system is running. I don't see anything going on there. Let's go ahead to the thermostat and turn it on. All right, we're going to put the system in cooling. And we're set at 60, so we should be running. Let's go back out to the outdoor unit there. Okay, so you can see it is running, and you can see that it's discharging warm air out of the top, but we're not getting good cooling in the home. So let's get our gauges out. We'll use our testo gauges because it's easier to see. Move them out of the way a little bit. Zoom in here on the discharge and suction lines. Okay, so here's our red hose, high side hose, and here's our high side temperature clamp. So we'll put those on the discharge line. Oh, it looks like I got them on the wrong one. There we go. There we go. Then we'll put the low side of the gauge on the suction side. We'll close up that cover so that we don't get our fingers zapped in there. Okay, so here's what we're looking at. We have 351 PSIG on the high side, saturation temp of 108 degrees Fahrenheit, 97 PSIG on the low side, saturation point of 30 degrees Fahrenheit, our line temperatures are 43 and 103 respectively. So we have 5 degrees of subcooling and 13 degrees of superheat. But if you'll notice, this 30 degree saturation point on the suction side indicates that the coil is going to begin to freeze because it is below freezing. We do have 5 degrees of subcooling, so we know we have a system that's charged properly. So just remember those numbers. We have 97 PSIG on the low side, 3351 on the high, 30 degree saturation temperature, 108 saturation temperature for the high side. The line set temperature is 43 degrees. On the suction, high side is 103 with 13 degrees of superheat and 5 degrees of subcooling. Okay, let's go to the indoor unit. Put our gauge away. Go to the indoor unit. We'll take the cover off. We'll replace the filter. Going to cost $115 to do that for the customer. You just got 4 stars because we did that right. And then we'll put it away. Put the cover back on. Let's go back to the outdoor unit and take a look at what's going on out here now. Unfortunately, you can't leave your gauges on when you're using the sim, so you got to go back and put them on again. Nope, got that on the wrong one again. There we go. Seems I always want to open up that door. Okay, so now let's take a look what's going on. If you remember, we had 351 PSIG on the high side. Now we have 391. The reason being that pressure's gone up on the high side is because we are now able to extract more heat from the indoor air now that the new filter's in there. So 391 PSIG, it was 351. 115 degree Fahrenheit on the discharge line, it was 108. It's now 102 degrees Fahrenheit on the discharge line. It was 103, and we have now 13 degrees of subcooling, which is a much better subcooling number than the 5 degrees. So now our subcooling is good. And look at what happens to our low side pressure. The low side pressure went from 97 to 118 PSIG and from 30 degrees Fahrenheit to 40 degrees Fahrenheit. That plugged filter really restricts the airflow, and restricted airflow lowers the suction temperature and the saturation temperature of the evaporator. And when the evaporator pressures go down, so do the condenser pressures. And you can see that from our, if you've taken your notes on that. And now we've gone up to 13 degrees, or back to 13 degrees subcooling. This is a TXV system, so subcooling is maintained. But now we're at 40 degrees coil temperature, and we won't be freezing anymore. So this is one of the simulations that we have in the course. It does tell you that it is an R410A system, and if we wanted to charge the system, we could do so by clicking the plus sign here, and we could remove refrigerant by clicking the minus sign here. So what we'll do in some future videos is we'll hook our gauges up, we'll hook it up to a properly operating system, and then we will overcharge it, look at what happens to the system pressures, then we'll undercharge it and look at the system pressures. The first thing you should do when you arrive at a call that has inadequate cooling is check that filter and make sure that the coil and the filter are clean before you throw your gauges on the system. All right, so we'll see you on the next video.